Hey guys, it is Tristan with Nerdette's Newsstand, and with just a little over 2 weeks until The Last of Us 2 is being released, we have some new information. Now, there is quite a bit of new information I didn't cover, whether it was state of play or otherwise, simply because this isn't a topic that's honestly well-liked on my channel, because most of you believe I am biased, and I want to show you something. And what I mean by that is I've talked about the false narrative that the haters of Naughty Dog, I guess I don't know how to say that, the people that dislike Naughty Dog, and again I want to reiterate how they did copyrights strikes were absolutely, I'm completely against that, but I want to show you something. So I was sent this video yesterday, and I'm gonna work backwards. Because there was two main points in this video, and mind you, no new information, but two main points. And it was completely a hoax. Like, the whole thing was fake. I'm not kidding you, it was based off of a lie. Now let's start from the back end of it, right? The most ridiculous in the fact that it is being basically said that the street date for The Last of Us 2 was broken somewhere in Poland, and the whole game was gonna be released. We were gonna see it all today, right? 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 Let's take a look at this picture. Tell me if you noticed anything a little bit funny. Like, obviously, it looks like maybe it could be a review copy, sure. You see a little bit of a reflection there at the bottom. You notice the edges aren't quite right when it comes to the packaging. Tell me what you really notice. Does anybody else notice that they took this off of a screenshot? That they have the mouse cursor right on her forehead? And yet this was reported as real? Like, really? Like, there's literally a mouse. And I'll zoom in for you. A mouse in her mouse little clicker thing in the middle of her forehead. This is not real. This was reported as real because it helped my agenda, or whatever you want to say. Like, this is ridiculous. It's not even hard to see. Like, you don't have to really zoom in to see any of this. All you have to do is simply look. So again, with the I hate Naughty Dog thing, and that's fine, I get it if you don't like them for the copyright strikes, but don't put false news out there because you need a video. That's fucking ridiculous. Now let's talk about the second half of the video, which would actually be the first half, according to that. There was a lot of complaints simply for the size of this game. Now, mind you, this is going to be a big game. We were told that it was going to take 20 to 30 hours to complete. You're paying $60+, depending on which, you know, one you get, for a game. You're getting your money's worth. You're absolutely getting your money's worth. But because of the file size, let's complain some more, right? So 100 gigabytes for this game. I have no problem with that because guess what? It's nothing new. Destiny 2 was 165 gigabytes. Red Dead Redemption was a little bit over 100, 105 gigabytes. Call of Duty, Black Ops 3, 100 gigabytes. Call of Duty Infinite War, like every single Call of Duty, 95 gigabytes. Elder Scrolls could take up to 120 gigabytes. And just recently, Final Fantasy, 100 gigabytes. Modern Warfare, another Call of Duty title, 175 gigabytes. So, is this abnormal? Is this a crazy huge size? Yeah, it's on the bigger end, but it is not that big of a deal. When you have these huge games, and I'm talking really in-depth games that take you a long time to beat, they are going to be larger. They are. And that's actually an indication of, you know, you're getting your money worth. Red Dead Redemption 2, as one of my other favorite games, is absolutely worth the money. So I don't understand where these complaints come from. I think they are simply to make a video. And I mean, we obviously know that that street date thing was absolutely completely a joke. Like, you tried, buddy. Whoever you were claiming to be from Poland and having this, you tried. You just had a massive fail there. So, another thing, And about The Last of Us. Now, this has nothing to do with the video I was sent, but I just want to show you guys something. It has obviously been a number one seller when it comes to Amazon all over the world. And that's great. I knew this was going to happen. And I did say in one of my videos that I thought a lot of these outrage was a little faked, right? I think not necessarily from the channels that were struck or anything. I'm talking about from Naughty Dog themselves. They got, my original, you know, thesis was that they got Anita Sarkeesian to help, not with the game, but with the outrage marketing. And it's worked really well because it is tracking better. It is tracking as, right now, to be the best PS4 exclusive ever. Right now, it is Spider-Man, which is another game that I just, it's a good game, but I fucking suck at it. I hate swinging. I hate it. Anyways, so, it is, it's tracking right now to do better. At this point, it is doing better than the best game ever as an exclusive. And Spider-Man went on to sell 13.2 million copies. Now, I know the original Last of Us over both systems, PS3 and PS4, sold 17 million. So I am guessing we are going to at least see that. Like, at least this could be Sony's best title, biggest title ever. And again, I could be wrong. This is just me thinking that, you know, if it's already doing this well, it is probably going to do even better. A lot of people are really interested in this game, regardless of leaks. And I want to talk, I'm not going to give any spoilers, but I do want to mention the fact that I believe it's tomorrow we can get impressions from reviewers that got it. So, and then the review date, I believe, I should have written it down before I did this video, but I think it's June 12th, the game comes out June 19th, the embargo date for reviews, right? So, generally, your embargo date is going to give you a good indication of how well this is going to do. So, I talked about this most recently when it came to Birds of Prey. The embargo date was, I believe, less than 48 hours before the movie hit theaters, right? So that means they don't have faith in this. They didn't have faith in Birds of Prey. They didn't want too many people to see too many reviews. They wanted to control that. If you have an embargo date that's a week out, that's a really, really good sign that this game is going to get good reviews. Now, of course, the early reviews that come out on the 12th, I would say, are not going to be completely 100% believable, of course, because they're gonna want to get those review copies next time around. You know, IGN, Kotaku, no way, I'm gonna trust them. I think maybe Eurogamer would be okay to look at, and I do believe they got a review copy. And I know Forbes didn't. That's kind of fucking hilarious, actually. But it's a shame, also at the same time. So I'm not sure. I'm not sure how you're going to believe, you know, reviews. I think the best way to do, if you're still on the fence about this game, is to wait till it actually comes out and see a actual YouTuber review. And I'm not talking about myself. Of course, I will review it, but I don't want to say, hey, trust me. No, do your research. Do, you know, go to multiple channels. Go to channels that, you know, were against this game, that hated it, did the fuck Naughty Dog thing, and then go to channels that were for it. So I think that's the best way to put it. We're also seeing that it is not being released in the Middle East. And yeah, it's censorship, but duh. Like, duh, did anyone expect any different? It's the Middle East. It is a lesbian relationship. Thank you, Captain Obvious. I knew this was coming. There was no way it was going to get released over there. It sucks. It's stupid. It really is. But even so, oh well. But I just think this is funny. Like, this was the fakest thing I have ever seen that people ran their story with. Like, come on. Be better. Be a little bit better. I'm not even asking you to be 100%, but my God. If you are doing this YouTube journalism, be a little bit better. Or at least take your video down and say, hey, it was fake. But no. Not everybody is exactly honest on here. So I just thought I'd let you guys know about this. I am excited, of course, for the game. Of course I am. That's not going to change. And I'm definitely going to be streaming it. But, you know, we still got a little bit over 2 weeks. So even so, let me know what you guys think. I will be checking out the impressions coming out tomorrow and seeing what we're, you know, if it's what we think. So I will see you guys in the next one. Hey. Hey guys, I want to give a huge shout out to my Patreon and subscribe stars. You guys literally make this channel possible. Huge thank you to Cage the Mick, Robert Mick Twiz, Black Knight Fool, Brucey, Chris Z, David L, David Rafford, Jeffrey Allen Carnes, Mighty Paws, Mike Buckner, Mizen Barbosa, Ruskart, Ryan Decker, Robert Hoffman, and Doc Holliday. You guys are absolutely amazing, and thank you so much for all your support. Don't forget on the way out to like as always if you enjoy the content and hit subscribe. And I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.